Hello and welcome to the session. In this session we will discuss basic locus theorem. First theorem that we have states the locus of a point equidistant from two fixed points is the right bisector of the straight line joining the fixed points. We can also say this as the right bisector locus. Let us now discuss the proof of this theorem. Consider case 1 in which we are given two fixed points P and Q and a moving point we taken as X in the statement of the theorem we have that this moving point X is equidistant from the two fixed points P and Q. So this means PX would be equal to QX. And in this case, we will prove that the moving point X lies on the right bisector of the line joining the two fixed points, that is PQ. So consider these fixed points P and Q, and this X is a moving point. We have to prove that X lies on the right bisector of PQ. For this, let us do some construction. Join PQ, then bisect PQ at Y. Also join PX, QX and XY. So we have joined PQ, PX, QX, XY and bisected PQ at point Y. Now let us start with the proof. Consider the triangles PYX and QYX. Now PX is equal to QX. It's given to us. Then PY is equal to QY by the construction that we have done, that is we have bisected PQ at Y, so PY would be equal to QY. Then YX is equal to YX, which is a common side for both the triangles. So therefore we can say that the triangle PYX is congruent to the triangle QYX by the SSS congruency criteria. And so we have angle PYX would be equal to angle QYX, as they are the corresponding parts of the congruent triangles, so they are equal. Now from the figure we can see that angle PYX plus angle QYX is equal to 180 degrees as they form a linear pair and the line PYQ is a straight line. Now since PYX and QYX angles are equal and also their sum is equal to 180 degrees, so this means that angle PYX is equal to angle QYX and each would be equal to 90 degrees, that is 180 degrees upon 2, which means that this angle is also of measure 90 degrees and this angle is also of measure 90 degrees. Therefore, we can say that XY is perpendicular to PQ and also Y is the midpoint of PQ. XY is perpendicular to PQ and Y is the midpoint of PQ. Hence we can say that XY is the right bisector of PQ, that is X lies on the right bisector of PQ. So this is what we were supposed to prove in this case. So hence proved for case 1. Now we consider the case 2. In this case we are given two fixed points P and Q. Also we have ST as the right bisector of PQ and we have taken a point X on ST, which is the right bisector of PQ. So here we have two fixed points P and Q and ST is the right bisector of PQ. This point X we have taken on the right bisector of PQ, that is on ST, and we have joined PX and QX. Now we have to prove that PX is equal to QX. Let this point be point Y. Now to prove PX equal to QX, we consider the triangles PYX and QYX. In these two triangles, we have angle PYX is equal to angle QYX and each is equal to 90 degrees. As we know that ST is the right bisector of PQ. Then we also have YX is equal to YX, that is the common side of both the triangles, and PY is equal to QY as ST is the bisector of PQ. Therefore, triangle PYX is congruent to the triangle QYX by the SAS congruency criteria. Now since these two triangles are congruent, so we can say that PX is equal to QX as they are the corresponding parts of the congruent triangles and so they are equal. And this is what we were supposed to prove. So hence we have proved the second case also. So in case 1 we have proved. Now in case 1 we were given two fixed points and a moving point which was equidistant from the two fixed points. And we have shown that the moving point lies on the right bisector of the line joining the fixed points. Thus, we say from the case 1 that every point equidistant from points P and Q lies on the right bisector of PQ, and in the second case we were given two fixed points and a moving point on the right bisector of the line joining the fixed points, and we have to prove that the moving point is equidistant from the two fixed points. So from case 2 we can say that every point lying on the right bisector of PQ is equidistant from the points P and Q. Hence, from this we can conclude that the right bisector of the straight line PQ is the required locus. That is, the locus of a point equidistant from two fixed points is the right bisector of the straight line joining the fixed points. Now let us discuss the next theorem, which says that the locus of a point equidistant from two intersecting straight lines consists of a pair of straight lines which bisect the angles between the two given straight lines. And we can also say this as the angle bisector locus. Let us now discuss the proof of this theorem. For this, we first consider the case 1 in which we are given two straight lines XY and PQ, and they both intersect each other at point O, and we have a point A which is the moving point. Let me take AN perpendicular to XY and AM perpendicular to PQ, and also this point A is moving such that AN is equal to AM. Now in this case, we need to prove that this moving point A lies on the angle bisector of angle XOQ, and we have drawn AN perpendicular to XY and AM perpendicular to PQ, and also AN is equal to AM. We have to prove that this point A lies on the angle bisector of angle XOQ. Let us first do some construction. In this, we join OA and reduce it to B. So we have produced OA to B. Now to start with the proof, we consider the triangles OAN and OAM. As you can see, these two triangles are right angle triangles. So now, in these two triangles, OA is equal to OA, which is the common hypotenuse for both the triangles, then AN is equal to AM. This is given to us, and also angle ANO is equal to angle AMO, and each is equal to 90 degrees. As AN is perpendicular to XY and AM is perpendicular to PQ, therefore from this we conclude that triangle OAN is congruent to the triangle OAM by the RHS congruence criteria, and thus we can say that angle AON is equal to angle AOM, that is, these two angles are equal as they are the corresponding parts of the congruent triangle, so they are equal. Hence, from this we can say that the moving point A lies on the angle bisector of angle XOQ. And this is what we were supposed to prove in case 1. Now, let us consider the case 2. In this, we are given that two straight lines XY and PQ intersect each other at point O. Also, OB bisects angle XOQ, and we have a point A on OB, then AN is perpendicular to XY and also AM is perpendicular to PQ. So we have two straight lines XY and PQ. We have OB as the angle bisector of angle XOQ, which means angle BOX and angle BOQ are equal. We have taken any point A on the OB, which is the angle bisector of angle XOQ, and we have drawn AN perpendicular to XY, AM perpendicular to PQ. Now, we have to prove in this case that AN is equal to AM. For this, we consider the triangles ONA and OMA. In these two triangles, angle ONA is equal to angle OMA and each is equal to 90 degrees, as we have AN is perpendicular to XY and AM is perpendicular to PQ. Then the side OA is equal to side OA, which is a common side to both the triangles, and also angle AON would be equal to angle AOM, as we know that OB bisects angle XOQ. Now from these three conditions, we conclude that triangle ONA is congruent to the triangle OMA by AAS congruency criteria. As these two triangles are congruent, so from here we can conclude that AN is equal to AM, as they are the corresponding parts of the congruent triangles and so they are equal. This is what we were supposed to prove in case 2. So hence prove this. In case 1, we were given two straight lines intersecting each other and we had taken a moving point equidistant from the two straight lines, and we had shown that this moving point A lies on the angle bisector of angle XOQ, which is the angle formed between the two given straight lines. Now from case 1, we conclude that every point equidistant from two intersecting straight lines PQ and XY lies on the bisector of angle XOQ, and in case 2, we were given two intersecting straight lines